Hi, let's talk about transient tachypnea of newborn today. When we have a baby with difficulty in breathing, we need to think about lung pathology and so heart pathology. And among the lung pathology, transient tachypnea of newborn is one of the most common differential diagnoses that we need to understand. So let's get started. So first of all, the most important thing to know is TTN is a self-limiting disease. It will resolve itself by time, usually in a few days. So what is TTN? So normally when the baby is inside mommy's uterus, they have some fluid inside the lung. And during the normal vaginal delivery, usually they will push out the lung fluid by the uterine contraction. And therefore, the lung fluid will go out. However, TTN is due to the delay of the resorption of lung fluid after the baby was born. So when you have many lung fluid inside, it inhibits the gastric exchanges and it leads to respiratory distress. So TTN is the most common cause of respiratory distress in newborn. So around 40% of the respiratory distress in newborn are due to TTN. So what are the risk factors? So the first most important risk factor is cesarean section. So when you have the cesarean section, you do not have the uterine contraction and the baby do not go through the vaginal canal. And therefore there is risk that we have the lack of pushing out of the lung fluid. Then the fluid stays inside your lung and it leads to respiratory distress. This is TTN. So another risk factor is breech delivery. Breech delivery means the food come out first when the baby was born. So normally if the baby has done, their head comes out first during delivery, they will have the trunk flexion. They will flex their tummy. So this trunk flexion will increase the abdominal pressure and elevation of the diaphragm. And this action will force out the fluid through the mouth and nose. So when the baby has the breech delivery, the food goes out first, there's lack of trunk flexion and lack of this. So the fluid will stay inside the lung and lead to TTN. So thirdly, infant diabetic mother. So this is mainly due to the increase in the risk of cesarean section. Baby with prematurity and late preterm also a risk factor of TTN. So how do they present? So think about it. When you have the fluid inside your lung, impair your gastric exchange. So obviously you have the respiratory distress. What are the signs of respiratory distress in baby? They will have the nasal flaring. They will have insucking chest. They will have tachypnea. And also they may have barrel chest. Barrel chest means your chest is like pushed out, more hyperinflated. Why hyperinflated lung? It's built due to the fluid inside the lung. So you may have the barrel chest. So it's present usually shortly after birth, within 6 hours of life. So usually after birth, the pediatrician saw that the baby has some difficulty in breathing and then admit them to the special baby care unit. They can be TTN. So how should we investigate that? So firstly, we can take the blood. For lung pathology, of course, you take the blood gas, take a look at the pH, take a look at the PCO2, any respiratory acidosis. And whatever happened in neonates, especially difficulty in breathing, one of the most important differential diagnoses are infection, congenital pneumonia, and therefore we need to rule out infection. We can take the blood for the complete background. Usually it is normal in TTN, but the white cell may raise in infection. We need to also take the inflammation markers like C-reactive protein and also blood culture because we need to rule out infection here. So chest X-ray. Chest X-ray, as mentioned, it is because of the fluid inside the lung, it may lead to hyperinflated chest, flattened diaphragm, and also due to fluid inside the lung, you can also see the fluid inside the interlobar fissure. And because this is not an infection, they will not have the area of consolidation. So how can we diagnose that? This is clinical plus radiological diagnosis. So if you think the baby has the risk factor like by cesarean section, they do not have the risk factor for like cardiac disease or congenital pneumonia, no evidence of meconium, which can lead to meconium aspiration syndrome. So after ruling out all of that, you may say that the baby has the TTN. So good news is this is a self-limiting disease. So how should we manage TTN? So mainly a supportive management. The baby with lung issue, respiratory distress, of course you need to give the respiratory support. You may give the nasal cannula, give some oxygen. For more ill baby, you may need non-invasive ventilation like CPAP, non-invasive positive pressure ventilation. And very, very rarely for TTN, baby may need intubation, but this is very, very rare. Do think about other differential diagnosis if the baby have need for intubation. So if the baby has significant respiratory distress, you may need to kneel by mouth and give the erythroid. Of course, for every baby, we want to maintain the neutral thermal environment. Medication. Usually, we don't need medication for TTN. However, in some hospitals, some practice, they will give the antibiotic for every respiratory distress baby because you cannot rule out the infection right away. And we can give the antibiotics until the infection excluded. For very severe cases, we may consider surfactant because they may have some component of lack of surfactant. But again, do think of other differential diagnoses like infection, like respiratory distress syndrome, like meconium aspiration syndrome if you encounter very severe respiratory distress. So, any prevention for TTN? So firstly, if we need to do the cesarean session, we should schedule the cesarean session to 39 weeks or later because this will prevent the TTN with more mature baby. We should allow vaginal delivery if possible. And also we should improve the antenatal surveillance to avoid low APGAR score because low APGAR score also can lead to TTN. So the prognosis, again, this is self-limiting. Usually it's resolved within 2 to 5 days with the supportive management. So in summary, TTN is a common cause of neonatal respiratory distress. TTN is self-limiting. If you see severe respiratory distress, do think about other differential diagnoses. Treatment are supportive. So thank you. See you next time.